Hello and welcome to my channel. I'm Dr. Tahir Yaqub, and in this video I'm going to show you 5 websites to get PhD scholarships and research grants. These websites are in US and Australia, and most of these provide funding to international students. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, since I live in Australia and I have a little bit story to tell you about this. So therefore I start from a website which is Australian government website, and this is called studyaustralia.gov.au, and this should be your starting point if you are planning your admission in Australia for master's, PhD or even for bachelor degrees. On the right hand side, if you see this logo and Australian government, you should be clear that this is an Australian government website. So this gives you a lot of information about Australia. For example, if you are bringing your children for scholarships and funding opportunities, and I will show you in a minute, but the starting point should be your apply to study. And here there is a chart here. This chart basically explains you everything about the admission process. So you choose to study in Australia. You have decided that you are studying in Australia. Then you decide an institute which you think that suitable for your department or your profession. Then after that, you check the entry requirements of that university or college, because all colleges have different requirements. IELTS score is not same. Other requirements are not same. Some will accept your degrees, some will not. Some will reduce the degree, a master degree, to a certificate or a diploma degree in Australia. I have seen this happening here, that you have a master degree in Pakistan, India and China, but when you come to Australia, they consider it equivalent to a certificate or a diploma. So check the entry requirements, then you apply for the course, and then you receive the offer letter. So this is the first step. And once you receive the offer letter, then you might have to submit few other documents, and basically then you will get the most important document, which is the confirmation of enrollment, because this is the document on which your visa will be accepted. So you submit this to your consulate office in your country, and then you get the visa and come to Australia. So this chart explains everything about the admission process. For every information about Australian government or institutes or immigration, I believe, it's my personal opinion, I am not an agent and I am not a representative of anyone, and this is not a legal advice, this is my personal opinion, that you don't need any agent. You do not need any agent. I never consulted any agent, and I got scholarships from Australian government for my master's, for my PhD, and I never got any agent. And my studies were fully funded by Australian government. As an international student, I did not have Australian citizenship or even permanent residence when I got the Australian scholarships. That was all on my own. And I studied all these websites, I put some time and energy and effort, but I got it. So this is my advice to you guys, that you probably don't need any agent. But if you decide to use an educational agent, or if your parent advised you to do that, it will make a little bit process easier, but you have to pay the money. So on the left hand side, you can see that there are education agents. If you click on that, then you will see this page. And on this page, if you click here, you will see few countries. And in these countries, you will not see like my country, Pakistan is not here. India is not, China is not here. Why? Because although these countries send most students to Australian universities, but these countries are not here. And the reason is that all these institutes, they have the list of approved agents of their own. So every university has their own approved agents, educational agents. And let me show you the list of UNSW, which is my university. So I did not use any agent, but this is their list. And this list is pretty much a comprehensive list, because as you can see, there are a lot of pages. And on these pages, their addresses, their phone numbers, for all countries and for Australia, everything is mentioned here. So hopefully you will find someone from your own country in this list. On this website, the second important tab is this one, Australian Education. If you click here, if you click on these scholarships, and you will see that these scholarships are for international students. And as you can see, this number is a huge number. that annual government investment for on international scholarships. If you are a UK citizen and you are looking for a US scholarship, or a Pakistani student looking for US, so you have to make sure that you are looking for international scholarships only, because most of the scholarships are not international. They are for local students, and this is hard to find. I personally got this international scholarship. At that time, it was called International Postgraduate Award. You can also get information about other things in Australia, like, for example, schooling. If you have a school-going kids, you must have to give them a school education. The children with school-going age must go to a school. So if you are on a government scholarship, then when I was doing this, that all your school fees were free. If you get a government scholarship, all your children fees will be free. So this is another advantage of getting the scholarship. Otherwise, you have to pay 8,000 or 10,000, whatever is the fees. So I think this website is fantastic source of information. No, this is another Australian program, and I think this is the best and the highest award in Australia, which is the Endeavour Leadership Program. And this program is on this website, internationaleducation.gov.au. This is for international students. So anybody can apply on this program. And this has the highest amount for a PhD or master's scholarships and executive programs, and also the vocational training. So this is for emerging leaders. So therefore, they called it as Endeavour Leadership Program. And if you are, for example, working as a dean or head of department in a university, and because mostly they have already PhD and they don't want another PhD, of course. So for these type of people, the program is executive program, and which is a continuous professional development program in which they can do some short courses, professional development courses in their own field of research. And they also have funding for masters and PhD, and this is a very good funding. As you can see here, that not only the tuition fee, but also the stipend and some travel allowance and a lot of things, as you can see on this page. I think every year by mid-November is their last date. So you have to apply before November every year. And in February or sometime they announce the award. So keep an eye on this website. It's a competitive award. Not everybody can win this easily. But if you have a good academic record, if you have few publications, or if you are at a good post, you might be qualified for this executive award. No, crdfglobal.org. So I think this website used to call Newton's List as well. So this is one of the leading websites which provides funding to global scientists and innovators, fellowships, grants, and training. Because I also belong to a scientist organization when I was in Pakistan. So I wanted to highlight this website, and this also provides the global funding. So not only the US institutes or US individuals, but it funds to the global community of scientists and innovators. So once you click on information for awardees, on the left hand side, you will see this very important link, before you receive your reward. And this is the link you have to click first. And when you click on this link, a PDF file will be opened. And on this PDF file is the most important information which you need if you ever want to get funding from a US government. And even if your business or if your institute is in Pakistan, India, Bangladesh, you can still get funding from US government. But what you need to do for that is you have to get this DUNS number. So this is the Data Universal Number System. So this is a number you have to get from this website. And this registration is absolutely free. You just have to provide certain information about your institute. For example, if you have an academy there, if you have a college or university or a scientific institute, or you are designing some innovative products, anything like that. So you have to register for this DUNS number first. And this is a complete process here mentioned here, that go to this website, you will find the link of the website, then you enter the information, and there are certain other things you have to do. So all that information is provided here. So if your institute does not have this number, so you can register and get a number, and then you are eligible to apply for the funding. And now coming back to our website, On this website, there is also on the main page, if you go back to this funding opportunities, and on this main page, there is a small filter here. So you can search for different technologies for which the funding is available. For example, this nuclear security, higher education. If you are a higher education institute, you can get funding, and energy. Energy sector gets a lot of funding. For example, if you are working on a solar energy or a renewable energy. So if you are working in any of these sectors, you can get funding. And in this video at the end, I will also show you some of the things, how to find the recent projects on which US government and other institutes, other sponsors are giving the funding. Because you want to make sure that you know the latest state of the technology, where you stand and where is the technology going forward and what kind of funding you can get. So if I get time in this video or maybe in the next video, I will show you some of the latest projects where people have got fundings and their details, what are the titles of their projects, what are the description of their projects, what are their stories. So all of these information I will put in one of my videos, and make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so you can get the notification whenever I post a new video. So you can see that if your institute, if your organization falls into any of these categories and you need funding, you can apply for a US government funding. Just get your DUNS number and then apply for the funding. So this is a fantastic website, and I hope that you guys are smart. Now you will take from here. Now, this is probably the most authoritative website in this video, which I'm gonna show you, grants.gov. This is a US-based website. And whenever you go to any website, first thing you want to see is the eligibility for the grant, whether you are eligible or not. The starting point for this website would be on this second tab, Learn Grants, and then second, the grants eligibility. So if you click on that, as you can see here that mostly these grants are available for state organization, for government bodies of US. But if you go down, you can see here that there is a component of this which is foreign applicants. And there are certain requirements for foreign applicants, mostly tax-based requirements, which you can easily fulfill. And just look at this, and what you will be applying for are the individual grants. So there are two kinds of grants on this website. One is organizational grants, and one is individual grants. So for both of these grants, you have to click here on the right-hand side on Register tab. So first you click on Register, and then register as an individual if you are a single person. And if you are an organization, so I'm not sure whether this gives a grant to the foreign organizations, but if you are a US-based organization, you can apply grant. But in both cases, whether individual or organization, you have to register first. So register on this website, and then in order to search for grants, there are two ways. First is the keyword-based search. So just type anything like, for example, education, enter. So you will see all these grants which are available for education sector. And if you click on any of these pages, you will go to the grant opportunity page. And here you can see the details of the grants, what are the requirements. So every grant is different. Some grant donors or grantors, they ask you to sign a contract for certain amount of publications or for certain amount of design patent or anything. So there are separate websites who deal with these type of technicalities of how to handle a grant application. And this we will discuss in one of the future videos, but you can see some information here on this website, on this grant page. Second method to research is on the left hand side, Learn Grants, and then Grant Programs. So on this page, they also mention some of the other websites. So this information is available here. So all these websites are in addition to what we are talking about in this video. So you can go on these websites and you can search on yourself if you are looking for some personal loans or for some personal grant benefits. So you can go on these websites and look into these websites that what opportunities are available to you. So a lot of information on this website, grants.gov. very good website. And another tab for applicant is this applicant tab. If you just click on this tab, so this will show you another page. And on this page, a lot of information is available, how to get started, how to apply for the grants and all the things. And the last thing I want to show you about this website is that this website contains some of the largest sponsors in US. And all those sponsors, if you look on into their websites, you might get some more information, and that is mentioned here. If you go to Learn Grants and then Grant Making Agencies. So if you click on Grant Making Agencies, so these are world's largest sponsors. So these are US-based sponsors, and not only US largest sponsors, but maybe the world's largest sponsors, these guys. All these websites, you can visit their websites and you can find some more opportunities on this on their own websites. For example, US Department of Energy is here. So I think that now you have a lot of information about funding websites, and you can just look on these and explore new fundings for your future projects. Now, this is the website of US Department of Energy. Purpose of showing this website to you is to give you an idea of what is going on in the scientific cutting edge area. So here you can see some of the success stories of people who have got fundings for their projects. So on this website, I would like to highlight only few things. So in programs tab, if you go down here, small business innovation and transfer of technology. So if you click on this link, and then you go to this success stories. So click on success stories. So then you will get a list of projects who are able to get the funding. Just read through these projects and see that what is going on in the scientific community. And for example, in nuclear physics, for example, there's a big funding for nuclear physics, which is very rare to find nowadays, because people say that physics is too much in advance of engineering. So, but this website also has a lot of information for other fields as well. The second thing I would like to show you is in this news section, scientific highlights. If you click on scientific highlights, now these are some of the other highlights of different projects. So as you can see that there are a lot of pages. So you can browse through all these as well, and you can also filter it from here, filter by the program. And here you can see that there are a lot of areas. So you can filter from here and you can see what is going on and what projects different organization and different people are getting funding. So this is the purpose of this website, to give you an idea of what projects are going on. So if you live in US, you can use this website to get funding. And if you live outside US, you can still get a lot of ideas from this website. So I hope that you find this video useful. If so, please subscribe to my channel, because that will help me to produce more of these videos. So thanks for watching. See you next time.